Hey, Chris, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. Back in late 2007, early 2008, just before the financial crash, I was the keynote speaker for a major automotive organization in the U.S. In preparing for that presentation, I recall speaking with one of the group's board members about the state of the economy and how it was impacting the auto industry at that moment in time. He was alarmed about all the subprime auto loans being written by certain banking institutions at that time. Not only did he foresee significant negative fallout for the car industry, he also saw it for the banks writing the subprime loans. But he also explained that his viewpoint was the minority opinion of those in his organization and on his board of directors. He was a lone voice of dissent. As alarmist as my discussion with him was, it was nothing compared to what actually happened later in 2008 when the auto industry and the rest of the economy collapsed. That collapse is still in process. It never really ended. Aftershocks and new quakes have been making their way around the globe ever since. And once again, it appears we are on the eve of another major calamity in the subprime auto market, a likely precursor of something much larger to come. An article this week on Zero Hedge discussed a gentleman who said he is considering filing bankruptcy. It's presented as a harbinger of things to come for subprime auto lending. It's about a father who bought a car for his son as a graduation gift for just over $11,000 with a down payment of $1,750. The kicker was the 29% interest rate for 4 years. The son had stopped making insurance payments, which should be the moral of this story, and then wrecked the car. The finance company ultimately sued the father, who had co-signed for over $15,000, which included principal, accrued interest at 29%, plus legal fees. They started garnishing the father's wages and have thus far taken just over $22,000. The father assumed the debt was almost paid, but thanks to the magic of compound interest at 29%, he still owes nearly $13,000. Lots of people are in this predicament. In the St. Louis area alone, where this situation occurred, since 2010, three auto finance companies have filed more than 15,300 lawsuits against borrowers in local courts. The vast majority of those cases resulted in a judgment against the defendant, after which the lender often sought to garnish wages from the borrower. Multiply this kind of activity across the country and you can see there is an epidemic of financial undercurrents that have never been fully acknowledged or explored since the 2008 financial crisis. Many who suffered in silent despair in 2008 and 2009 have been caught in what amounts to a massive undercurrent of financial waterboarding that never seems to end. This is just one more example. There will be some listeners to this who will scoff and say how stupid it is for anyone to take out a car loan at 29% interest. Yes, it's really a bad idea. But the fact is, some people have no other option, no other access. If you don't know any of those people, I would beg to differ, because you most likely do. You may just not recognize the situation or them. But one thing I am very certain of is that during the next economic collapse, there will be even more people that fall into this kind of a category. And no matter how well you or your family think you have prepared, you may very well end up being one of those individuals yourself. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, reminding you to follow us on Twitter at ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. For two new big guests, be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.